Расцветали яблони и груши.
Let Stalin guide us.
Выходила на берег Катюша, на высокий берег на
Yo guys, what is going on? Fly here. Welcome back to the channel. Today we continue our tank request series with Shane Lee Yang. A little old request, but a good number of votes for the T28 Magic School Bus. So this tank is really, really fun at 2.3, but we have to watch out for, I think, two tanks only-ish if we get up-tiered, or one if we get up-tiered, the other one if we don't. But that is the Valentine and the Matilda. Yo, so these are my most feared tanks when I'm playing the T28. Okay, the Valentine, let's... Wait, I thought there was a 2.3. Oh, yeah, here we go. Okay, so let's put these two in action real quick so we can compare them real quick. But before I talk more about the British tanks, let me just show you the whole point of this conversation right here. Is that the T28, let's bring this one up, has its top penetrating shell is 68 millimeters at 10 meters. Or where we would normally engage a Matilda or a Valentine would probably be at 100 to 200 meters. So our penetration might be 63 to even below that, maybe 58 millimeters of penetration. But the reason why these things are so scary when you're in the T28 is because, let's just start with the Valentine first, is that from the front, this is the Matilda, from the front it is very hard to penetrate this thing. Okay, so level ground, you know, our round's just gonna bounce right off the upper plate. You can't go through here unless we're very, very close. And if we are very, very close, it's an RNG to see if we can get there. Because the T28 is very tall and shooting down would create its own angle. And the turret's very strong as well. We're not getting through the turret. So when I see this thing front up, I'm just, okay, rip, game over. But there is one little spot right here that we can go through if we aim perfectly and we are in range. The side armor is pretty darn trolly. You know, the turret, we can go side turret if we flank around them. This has a pretty good chance of bouncing, so I'll probably just shoot. Oh my god, what was that right there? I don't know. Hopefully I can go right through here, but just telling you, the Valentine's very hard, and the Matilda, just get the fuck out of here. You're not going to penetrate this thing really anywhere from the front. It's a freaking beast in its own sense. Side armor. Now, I don't know what the side armor really is. I think I can get a little bit of a glance of it. It's like right here, maybe. Oh, there it is. So it's 40 millimeters thick, but we have a 25 millimeters of, you know, shirt skin or side armor, and then we have the tracks to go through. So if we see one of these things, it's gonna be really scary, and I'm gonna try to run away as quickly as possible. But the T28's really, really fun if you get the, what is that over there? Is that us? Yep, that's us. If you get proper matchmaker. Now, I do have some backups for, or like to complete the mission. We have the SU-57, the BM-824, and the I-53. But guys, please, in the comments below, let me hear what tank you would like me to play out next. And without further ado, let's go. All right, guys, so here we go. We are on Berlin. I think the strategy this map is that we're just gonna be pushing all the way down this road, then taking a right and hopefully trying to flank them a little bit. You know, everyone knows to go there if you wanna get around the enemy, so we're probably gonna have to deal with some opposition from the front. But if this is, oh shit, we're versing the British. But look at that, we're pretty early to the game. We might be able to set our tracks in some nice mud and hunker down. Now, the thing that makes the T28 really fun to play is, first of all, it has good mobility and good top speed. We're already at 40 kilometers an hour, which gets us around the battlefield very nicely. But the downside of that is that that top speed is in direct result of not having that much armor. But if you play to your best, you won't really need the armor because you'll be there before the enemies are expecting you. And then if the 76 millimeter round is to penetrate, it's usually a one shot. And if it's not, then you have an easy follow-up shot because the reload rate on this gun is just fantastic. We're gonna take a right after this building. And then you have three forward-facing machine guns that just destroy anti-aircraft vehicles. You know, these have to be open top or the unarmored ones. But it does add a little bit of, fuck, dude, he came in quick. We're stuck here for a little bit.
We gotta move though. We're two in the open. Holy shit. See that M3 Lee just come out of there? He's pushing all the way over here to the left.
Attention to the map.
I don't want to spend too much time on this guy because I have to deal with other things. We were a little bit late to the party, obviously. We got a lot of people over here. We got an A-13. Anti-aircraft. We're still okay. I shouldn't have turned full horizontal. Okay, he's down. Our driver's back up. Everything's fine. Holy crap. What an extreme beginning to this game. Okay, he's down. Now let's just relax here. I really need to get out of here because I'm still in the open for people shooting me from across the map. Let's just scout that out real quick. It looks pretty clear. I'm going to move into the city area. That M3 lead distracted me entirely. Now, what I shouldn't have done right there is, I said before, I just want to reiterate this. Is I should have stayed my angle against that M16 or M13, but I was scared he was going to set me on fire. But I kind of panicked right there, but we're still okay. We got an enemy tank in front of us. We got a good shot right here if we need to. Okay, Tango down right there. I'm not going to push up much more with the British tanks having that speed, man. It is hard to get into position, but... for the Soviets, especially a tank with this kind of gun, its speed is nice. And the thing is, the thing that gave me a lot of confidence early game was that there wasn't that many people spawned into the game yet. I thought I was one of the first spawners. Okay, so we got some shots over to the left. That might be the M3 Lee still up there. I can't see that. I'm going to focus middle. We got a T-50 going in for him. He'll be fine. All looks clear. Okay, we're going to push down. We're going to take a little bit of a... No, I'm going to push down Main Street. I'm going to push down Main Street here. Now, let's just keep our eyes out, eyes open for the right, as we do have a tank over there right now. We got one tank in front of us as well. Let's deal with the people in front of us first. Go for that big old turret he's got. No penetration. Look at that right there. That's something. We'll go for his bottom. Okay, a little bit of... Jeez Louise. I thought that guy was going to be easy prey, but he was able to penetrate me for a little bit. We're okay. Let's keep moving up. The good thing about the T-28 is that we have that crew to replace if we get him taken out. Let's go look right. So I saw an enemy tank over here, and plus we can get in a good position to defend in case anyone wants to pop back out. It's supposed to be a hard shot, but let's see if we can get it. No, he's already gone. Okay, six is cleared. Now, something risky we could do right now is push all the way up to the left. I think we should, man. No one really expects this early in the game. Oh, fucking hell, guys. Should we even shoot at this guy? Nope. We can shoot at this guy all we want, though. Oh, come. Oh, my gosh. No, don't go away. Okay, there we go. Tango down. Let's get the fuck out of here because the Valentine's over there. Oh, I knew versing the British would be hard. Okay, now we're flanking around entirely. Let's just watch over here in case any new tanks are up. Okay, let's turn right. We gotta be quick though because if we stay here too long, too many new spawners will spawn up and we'll get caught in the mix. Now, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to... I don't want to spawn kill, but I want to get these guys off of their rocks behind these houses over here. We can make the right turn right now. I think we'll be good to go. Maybe it's all cleared out, huh? Yeah, we got a T-70 over here, all cleared. Man, oh man, I thought... Oh shit, I'm fucked. What the fuck? Don't shoot me, don't shoot me, don't shoot me like that. Missed my gunner. Alright, got his driver. Yes! Saved by the T-70. Thank you, man. Okay, so he's down. We got 5 kills. They are capturing A, so what we can do... We got an enemy behind us, I think. We'll be on the reload in a second, or we'll be fully repaired in a second. This guy has to be dead, right? Come on, Russian Depression. Okay, good, he's dead. Now, it seems like a lot of the enemies still alive in this game are at A, so we're gonna head over there. Scratch that, we just cleared out all of the A contenders. We're just gonna kinda hunker down here and make sure no one gets back into this battle. This right here is good. Holy shit, look at him! Oh shit, look at this. Oh god, we need to rescue our T-70 right now. We got a T-17 up, and he just went full, yeah. I don't know if the T-70 needs help, but we'll just double check here. Now where did that guy go? Oh! Yeah, he almost got me right there, dude. Alright, that's probably going to do it for this game. We ended up with 6 kills and clean the game up. Now, we got pretty darn lucky this game. I thought we were gonna get outed early. Yes, so this is going to be the map where we can exceed 10 kills. White Rock Fortress with the mobility to flank. Maybe this is the wrong... I spawned... I'm on the wrong spawn, but hopefully we can still do something like this. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be flanking across all of this, getting behind them a little bit. Not spawn camping, but definitely holding them back from pushing into our objective. What I wanted to do was spawn on this side and push down here. But honestly, the best spawn for this map is on the enemy team this way. I don't know why it's just easier to clean this way up than to clean this way. But we're going to work down and work our way up. And we should be able to flank the entire team if they're not smart enough to come up here. Are we reversing? Oh, we're reversing exclusively the British. So you know we're going to see a Valentine. Hopefully not a Matilda. Please, God, no. Not the Queen of the Desert. This is a White Rock Fortress, so she might be in there. Now, should we cut down to the left or just kind of go up here? But you know what? I'm going to be extra careful right now and just pop all the way down. Okay, contact spotted in front. I don't know if I want to shoot yet. Okay, good. Cromwell up here. This one we can shoot at. Okay, beautiful shot right there. Is that a Valentine? A Valentine's here. Oh, he didn't see me. We just got so lucky. Oh man, another one? Okay, no, it's clear. Okay, I thought I saw another kind of turret up there. All right, now we're gonna push up and try to find that Crusader and hopefully clear off the whole entire enemy's push on this side. Look at this maneuverability. Oh, there he is. How convenient. Let's get the gun ready. I don't think he has quick turret rotation. What a piss poor shot, and somehow it penetrated. Okay, now if we look to the left, I think we'll just pop out here, see if anyone's that we can shoot. An Oh, I think it might be game over already. There's not that many enemies over here. What can we do? So we got 3 early game kills. I'm going to push for the center of the map. This might be risky, but if there still are players alive, they'll be in the middle of the map right now. All right, so pushing up. Tango spotted right here. Got a nice little cute archer. Man, one-shot machine, man. Okay, so he's down. That's the guy that we just shot who's popping up on the radar. Ooh, yes, we got a Valentine right here. I don't know if we can do this, but we'll try. Where the fuck did he go? Okay, there he is. Lucky shot right there. Now, I wonder if there's anyone else still over there. Who's this right here? Dead tank. Okay, now I think I'm going to start pushing for their cap. We've done some really good work. We got 5 kills early game. Oh, yeah. I'm pushing right for cap. They don't got any kind of recourse right now. All clear so far. Oh shit. We got a Crusader right here. I've took down both of his tracks. Some pretty poor shooting right there. I wasn't expect someone to be still up here. Now, I don't want to focus all my attention on this guy just because I'm still in open territory. Okay, got a nice shot on his right or left cheek, if you want to call it that. We got a Crusader Mark II down there. Our gunner's out. Let's turn a little bit here. Come on, Gunner, wake up, wake up. Oh, crap. We should have stayed up there and just chilled out for a little bit longer. I would say the hardest nation to play against as a T-28 would be the British, because they have the combination of quickness, amazing. Can I get over this? Probably not. This is, no, I definitely cannot. They have the combination of quick fire rate, quick tanks, and then on the other hand, they have heavy tanks with still quick fire rate, and with me having no armor, they can make so... Oh, fucking hell, I think I see it, boys. I'm not even gonna shoot at it. I really can't do anything against it. I'll shoot at it once. Like, it's the scariest thing to see, dude. Really is scary. Oh, well the Panzer III makes short work of it. Okay, nice easy kill right there. Get another tank right here, it looks like. Something. It looks like a Crusader again. They just have that quick fucking fiery gun. This is an A-13, actually. Poor reverse speed. Oh, we weren't able to land the penetrating shot. There we go. Our teammate got him. I just fear the British at this tier. I really, really do. Okay, but we're going to be in the cap soon. I'm going to get into a position to defend from incoming tanks from their spawn. Just kind of like right here. I think that's it. Oh, shit. Oh, my. No. Side turret, please. Oh, my God. We got so lucky right there. It's just where you're positioned. Where you're able to succeed. Fuck, man. Where can I shoot this thing? Maybe more of the side? We're gonna go where the engine set on fire, maybe. Okay, there we go. Engine set on fire or just killing it from the rear? God, the poor 3-inch gun carrier. What a beautiful looking tank. All right, I think that's gonna do it. That's enough carnage from the enemy team. And like, one of the reasons why low tier battles are so fun is because stuff is so cheap to spawn back in the battle, is that the battle lasts much longer than top tier games. And plus, more people play lower tier because it's more relaxing and more fun. Well, guys, we have another tank pushing up, a Valentine. Now, I wonder if I build up some speed and try to flank him. That is his spawn, but he already got a kill out of that. It sounded like he was pretty close to that Panzer when he shot him. Let's see what this Panzer IV up here thinks about it. Does he see him, you think? It looks like his turret's rotating in that direction. Looks like he's trying to fire on it. He might not have the depression to get it. He is trying to commit, though. You son of a gun. Why couldn't you see the guy on top of the ledge way over there? Alright, but we took a hit. We're on the repair. Good thing about the T218. We have so many freaking crew members in here. It's not a problem at all. So that is going to do it, boys. I want to thank you guys for voting on this series and the ongoing support on this channel. I really appreciate it. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. Have a great day, and until next time, peace out, boys. Thank you.